Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. In an earlier video, I talked about three different ways that you could state the confidence interval. And one of them was this way, where you have the population proportion in the middle and your value, your lower limit and your upper limit value here. Another way is to state it this way, like you might have done in an algebra class somewhere. And finally, you can state p hat plus or minus e in this way. So in this problem, it says, given the confidence interval from 0.452 up to 0.624, find p hat and e and state the answer in this format. Well, we know that this value is p hat minus e, and this value is p hat plus e. But how do we know what those two values are? I just want you to take a look at what that would look like if we were to put it on a graph. We have p hat, and if we add e onto that, we get to here. And if we subtract e from that, we get down there. So this is really a range of values that we have in here, with p hat sitting in the middle of those. So what you want to do is take your larger value and subtract the value at the bottom. That's going to tell you the difference between these is this span right here. So we're going to take 0.624 and subtract 0.452 and then divide that by 2. So we want the whole distance, and then we just want to divide it by 2 to figure out what one of these distances are. Because this is p hat plus one of those values, right? And this is minus one of those values. And that gives us 0.086. So that tells us what e is. So we want to then subtract e from the upper value. I mean, you can subtract it from the lower one. You just get a negative number. But I think it's easier just to think of it as taking the upper value, 0.624, and subtracting the e that we just found. And that tells us what our p hat is, 0.538 right here. If we add 0.086, we get here. And if we subtract 0.086, we get there. So our answer states then as 0.538, that's p hat, plus or minus 0.086, that's e. And that could also be stated as an interval. This number would be this up here, sorry. This interval comes from the actual interval that we see up here. It doesn't look like this is the same thing, but if we take this value and subtract 0.806, that would be that value. And if we add it, that would give us that upper value. So those are the ways you can move between those three different ways to state that. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you next time.